Quite a long time ago, I got a request to show more about my construction techniques. And the first video that I made was from the more or less ideal breadboard from, say, a few days ago. Made with a wood birch triplex and shielding on the backside. And perhaps this video is going to be very long anyway. Construction techniques. I mentioned in that earlier video that we have here the positive lead, the negative lead, constantly soldered here to the shielding and also to the shielding on the backside. And in my younger days, I tried to make a more or less professional looking audio amplifiers, etc., etc., but it took such a long time. So don't be ashamed that you cannot make an audio amplifier that looks like it is sold in the shops, but that doesn't mean that you cannot make high quality circuits as a radio amateur or an electronic amateur. Anyway, here for instance is that IF amplifier that I published a few hours ago, and I want to look over that circuit again with the help of a magnifying glass. The IF filter, the input coupling capacitor, the output from that filter goes to the field effect transistor, drain, source, gate, I've indicated, and that's very helpful. Decoupling capacitor from the field effect transistor, and after that the one stage audio amplifier or IF amplifier with the detection diode that's here in the middle of the screen now. It's an OA81 or a 1N90. These are germanium diodes that are very useful to be used as diodes that can detect an amplitude modulated signal. And that's here in the circuit, this diode, the OA81, detects the amplitude modulated signal. Here it's very, very much amplified. Here we have the mixer from the circuit. So the high frequency goes in here, and with that potentiometer we set the mixing effect, and here we send in the VFO signal, and that will be in this radio here going from 15 megahertz up to 20 megahertz or perhaps 22 megahertz or so. And we have here the filter from for 50 kilohertz that I've showed earlier. So construction techniques, I want to mount this circuit completely mounted on wood with brass nails and push pins. It's a very good way to make a simple circuit. And I will mount this IF amplifier here on the breadboard from that radio. That will be the second step. And the reason that I mounted it on wood was that it was very cumbersome to make the circuit here pushing all the push pins or brass nails in. So that's too difficult. So I made it in a separate way. And of course, after all, the miners here will be connected to the shielding plate at the backside from this radio circuit. So I will drill some holes and then connect the miners to the tin plate to give it a good shielding. Also, the IF amplifier must be shielded on its backside, on its miners. We see now here the signal on the scope, 450 kilohertz amplified far too much by this transistor, the BC547B, but I've made a direct connection from the field effect transistor to the end transistor that detects the AM signal, and that means that we don't see a good sine wave, but anyway, everything has to do with the filter here, and that filter is still in an experimental stage. You can see it here. It's that yellow filter, and I have to align it properly to tweak it to the same frequency where this coil filter is tuned to. So that was more or less all to tell about construction techniques. Don't be ashamed when you make these kinds of circuits on wood with brass nails, push pins, etc., etc. Don't compare your products to professional circuits. Of course, when you want to go to the professional way, everything has to be figured out, because when you want to make, for instance, such a circuit on a copper clad board, that is a new experience, and you have to find that completely out. Could be that this wiring does not work on a copper clad board. Anyway, this works good, and everything has to do with the low inductance, the low stray capacitance, the low stray resistance. That's everywhere, because this piece of wood is very well varnished. So there is no leak current, no leak capacitance to other parts of the electronic circuit. And also that's the case here. Well varnished wood, brass nails, push pins, and there's an extremely high resistance between the push pins or the brass nails. And that makes that such a circuit can work very, very good.